we may interpret Jnana Shunya Bhakti like that, learned ignorance. Learned ignorance is when learning understands, is when learning understands its own limits. When one realizes, I'm finite, my learning is also finite. Learning cannot make me a bona fide inquirer about the infinite. Learning is not the way to grasp. It is better to surrender to the infinite and let him work within us for our best interest. Very nice expression. Let him work inside you for your best interest. One time I was thinking, for example, why a musician want to learn how to play, you know, some music, you know, and he tried 1, 2, 3, 10 times, and he's always doing wrong, and from doing wrong. Means to do it nice, well. Why? Why from wrong becomes good? I was saying, well, it's only because Krishna's mercy. Only because it has no sense. If I am doing always a mistake, why from there will come something good? For me, it has no real sense. But things are like this, from doing things many times, making always the same mistake, and thus we don't do the mistake. Why? I see that Krishna is teaching us, you cannot do it by yourself. Only because of my mercy you will do it. You will understand. It is better to surrender to the infinite and let him work within us for our best interest. He is not static. He will work for your best interest. So nicely explained. Why in a classroom, no? Some students understand mathematics problem. There are some students who understand. I never could understand how they could understand. For me, it was a very mystical power. It's only because of Krishna's grace. Many times you show Bhagavad Gita to a friend, and he don't understand. And you cannot believe how you can understand. It is so clear, so important. One time I was speaking about reincarnation to some of my cousins, and one of them said, even if I believe it in reincarnation, that will not change my life in nothing. My God, I begin to accept reincarnation. That was a revolution in my mind. It changed everything in my points of view. But to others, it's the same thing. They become more in mind. Mind is so powerful. Now everybody say yes.
We know each other from many lifetimes.
Yes.
Now we are meeting again.
In this way they want to continue this in the Mayan. It is better, no, submission, surrender to the infinite is the highest reach of learning.
As Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, Jnanavam Mam Prapadyati.
Those who are really learned, they surrender to me. Learned ignorance means to realize that we can't know, that we can't know the infinite. If he makes himself known to us, then we can know him, otherwise not. Question. Nicholas of Cusa said, God is inconceivable by thoughts. It's inconceivable by thoughts. What do you say about this?
Sri Maharaj says, yes. Only through devotion and by His grace may God be known.
Our cultivation of knowledge won't give us God. That is the failure of knowledge. Investigation about God, the infinite, is a failure. If you try to investigate about God through your own knowledge, you will reach to Brahman. Only to light, you will negar, as a negar.
Negate.
So it's very dangerous. But we saw how Arjuna got everything through surrendering. We will understand everything because Krishna will show completely to us. Hare Krishna. If there are questions or doubts. Also Sri Maharaj says, why not doubt of doubting? Why people have so much faith on doubting? What they are gaining with this doubting? So don't have faith in doubt. It's better to try through surrender. Now the whole society has faith in doubt, but they have nothing. They have only doubts. And doubts means anxiety. Uncertainty. Certain, very sad situation. Quite nice expression, no? If we surrender, Krishna will work inside us for our benefit. He will give intelligence. I will give intelligence and the will understand. Pratyaksha Bhagavyam Dharmyam, Krishna says, you will realize directly. There will be no doubt. You were commenting this yesterday. Yes, okay.